In this video, I'm going to explain how we've changed and added to the term page to give you what you've been asking for. The term page is simply where SpyFu gives you a bunch of data about a keyword that you're looking up. I'm going to type in a keyword. Guitar. And the new harmonious term page gives you incredibly helpful information about the keyword you just typed in. First and foremost, monthly searches. We'll show you how many people on average searched for this keyword and even give you specific numbers based on location, local and global. We expanded this data for broad, phrase, and exact match keywords. We then give you the average cost per click, showing you the same broad, phrase, or exact info for both cost per clicks and the amount of clicks that you're estimated to get daily. This section shows you the daily cost of this keyword, and if you look closely, you can see the monthly cost as well. If you want even more at-a-glance info, you can see how many advertisers have been buying this keyword over the last 3 months. If you want to see how any of this data has changed over time, you can click on the graph icon and get an easy view of the last year. Since I usually like to see the current status of my keyword, I'm going to hide this graph for now. For a more detailed list of the advertisers and the actual ads that they've been running, all you have to do is click on Advertisers, and it will automatically scroll you down to the details of this. On the organic end, you can see how many home pages appear in the top 50 results. A home page being something like guitarcenter.com instead of guitarcenter/electricguitarguitar.gc. This is an important metric because, in general, the more home pages that appear in the SERP, the more difficult that keyword will be to rank on. For guitar, reasonably stiff competition, 25 home pages. That means that half of the top 50 results are going to lead you to a home page, making that possibly difficult to rank on. But if you type in the keyword flowers, it's even more difficult at 32 home pages. If you type in fish tacos as a keyword, that number drops to 7. This is starting to sound like the search history of someone going on a first date. When you click on the top 50 organic, you can see all the URLs that are ranking on the top 50 on this keyword, as well as a bunch of other handy SEO metrics. The ranking difficulty is probably the most important metric of them all. We also show it up at the top, and it's a new feature to SpyFu. It simply shows you how difficult it will be to rank on this keyword relative to other keywords. It's not on a scale of like 1 to 1,000, but instead it's a raw number you can relate to the other keywords you're debating on. So if I compare this number to, let's say, guitar lessons, you can see that guitar is more difficult to rank on. Of course, it's a little tedious to compare ranking difficulty one by one. That's why we give it to you in a handy column in the profitable related keywords section, so you can, at a glance, see where this keyword stands amongst its peers in terms of difficulty. We'll go more into this section in a little bit. We already talked a little bit about homepages, but another indication of difficulty is how many .gov and .edu domains are ranking on this keyword. Traditionally, Google gives more weight to .gov and .edu domains than they do others. The word guitar doesn't have any, but if we type in the word guitar school, and bam, 2.gov edu domains in the top 50. SpyFu lets you know how many results has the keyword in the title of their link page. This is another very strong indication of a high rank. We put the corresponding title text in bold to show you exactly what it says. We also bold the domains that have the keyword in the URL itself. One of my favorite new features is that we alert you when there's social domains ranking on this keyword. Social is huge, and it's important to know what content on which major social network currently rank on this keyword, and where there might be social opportunities for the ones that aren't. These vary per keyword with notable results. Guitar is ranked on Wikipedia and YouTube. Probably people wanting to watch guitar tutorials online and want to know what a guitar is. To give you a completely different example, the keyword Martha Stewart has a lot of social presence, including Facebook, Twitter, Wikipedia, and Pinterest. Compared to Tim Ash, who is another person with a brand-like status, he's also on the main sites, but instead of the more craft-centric Pinterest, he's on the more businessy LinkedIn. Because social is such a huge part of how people find things, you should use it to your advantage, especially when there are gaps. If you're wanting to rank on chocolate chip cookie recipe, you might want to follow Martha's example and leverage your Pinterest or Tumblr posts. If it's a business profile opportunity, like Mary Kay, you might want to consider LinkedIn. Okay, we also show you how many estimated monthly clicks the top ranked page gets and what those clicks are worth in terms of dollars. This is a big deal when wanting to attach a monetary value on SEO clicks. It's a great way of prioritizing your list and also to show a potential client how much money they can make with more SEO work. And in the rightmost column, you can see how many estimated clicks per month these domains at their current ranks are getting. You can see the clear drop-off as you move down the ranks, and the huge difference between the top-ranked domain and the 10th-ranked domain. Another feature is the total search results Google gives for this keyword, and its domain diversity. The domain diversity describes the variety of domains ranking on this keyword. So if just one domain is ranking in all top 50 spots, that means the domain diversity is 2%, 1 out of 50. If we go back to the Martha Stewart example, you can see that she has a domain diversity of 39%. That's pretty low. Not as low as 2%, but still pretty dang low. That's because there's a brand effect happening here that might make this keyword pretty difficult to rank highly on. Google is clearly favoring MarthaStewart.com for the keyword Martha Stewart, and this makes a lot of sense. But not all keywords are branded like this. For the keyword home interior pictures, Google is favoring house.com and places it in the second, third, and fourth spot. Whether Google is doing this manually or if house.com's SEO team is working well with the algorithm is not entirely clear. Regardless, this one domain is clearly dominating in the ranks. The same goes for a keyword with a high domain diversity, like guitar. It's in the 90 percentile, which could either mean that it's a highly competitive word or simply a very fragmented market. In this particular case, I'm going to guess it's the former since the ranking difficulty is so high on guitar. But the domain diversity is a metric to tell you the story behind a keyword and the domain's ranking on it, not necessarily how difficult it is to rank on it. If you scroll down to the actual domain list, you can see that MarthaStewart.com has two little icons by it. One is a blue times 30 icon. This means that MarthaStewart.com pops up on 30 separate ranks in the top 50, which is probably why it has such a low domain diversity. If a domain ends up in the top 50 only twice, then it'll have a little box that says times 2. The other icon that you see says add. This means that MarthaStewart.com is also advertising on this keyword. It's important to know where your clients are double dipping on keywords. It might be smart for them to cut back on their PPC campaign if they're already ranking highly organically. It can also be beneficial to see where your competitors are ranking organically and buying ads. It might be an indication of a strong keyword. And of course, you can see the exact rank and how it's changed over the last month by scrolling to the far left under the rank change column. On the far right, you can see a column called domain strength. This is on a scale from 0 to 100. The higher the number, the more formidable the domain. MarthaStewart.com is a pretty strong domain on this scale, but if you look, you can see that 1 is at a full 100 strength. Wikipedia.org. No surprise there. Finally, if you want to double check our data, you can always click on the cache cert page link and see a screenshot of the actual page that we took all this data from, and also see the date that we pulled it. Okay, enough about SEO. Let's go back to the keyword guitar and give you some PPC goodness, like the click-through rate. This is Google's estimate to how many people saw your ad compared to how many people clicked on it. So if 100 people saw your ad and only 2 clicked on it, that would be a click-through rate of 2%. We already talked about the ranking difficulty metric, so let's talk about my absolute favorite thing in the new SpyFu term page. The universal search in SERP. When searching for something in Google, it no longer just gives you links to pages. It also gives you links to Google News, images, videos, places, and shopping. Universal search is an opportunity to get new content noticed on the SERP, not just traditional pages. Take note on what current content is ranking and where there might be gaps that you can fill in with your content. Finally, if you'd like to track this keyword every week, you can add it to your own personal SERP tracker. We make it really easy to add it to any of your existing SERP tracking campaigns, or you can just add a new one. You can also do this with any related keywords you think might be profitable. This makes tracking a bunch of different keywords in a similar vein a snap. You don't even have to be buying them to add one of them to your campaign. You can just keep an eye on how they're doing to determine whether or not you want to advertise on them in the future. We give you some of our suggestions in the profitable related keyword section, and also give you all the handy data you got above, including whether or not it's a phrase match keyword, its monthly searches, ranking difficulty, cost per click, and so on. You can also use the drop-down on any of these headers to specify the match type data you're wanting to see. This can be individualized for each column. If you scroll down just a little bit, you can see the actual ads that people have run for this keyword. The boxes represent the ad. You can click and see the actual ad copy used. And just like in profitable related keywords, you can see an expanded list of this by clicking View More. This list is also versatile. If you click on More Actions, you have a bunch of options, including to see the actual SERP page screenshot, or export all ad variations, or even see a 6-year history of this keyword. We hope you enjoy the new term page and all the data it gives you about your keywords, or your competitors. Thank you for watching.